Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent and the Most Merciful. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome to the virtual science class. Today is our 22nd lecture about electromagnet. This is chapter 16. In this chapter, we will learn about the introduction of electromagnetism, magnetic field, demagnetization, creating an electromagnet, and electromagnetism in daily life we use. Electromagnet. A magnet is a material or object that produces a magnetic field. This magnetic field is invisible but is responsible for the most notable properties of a magnet. A force that pulls on other ferromagnetic materials such as iron and attracts or repels other magnets. Attractive property: magnet attracts ferromagnetic material. Repulsive property: like magnetic poles repel each other and unlike magnetic poles attract each other. As we learn in the electricity that both same charges or like charges repel each other and opposite charges attract each other. Same in the magnet, like poles repel each other and the opposite poles attract each other. Directive property: a freely suspended magnet always points in a north-south direction. Now we have this article on page 100. Open your books. Page 100, unit 16, electromagnets. Magnets do not always attract one another. A magnet has two poles, a north pole and a south pole. If you have a bar magnet at your home, you see that one end, it is written that N, and that portion will be red and the other is black where they write S, south pole. Every magnet has two poles, north pole and south pole. The north pole of a magnet will never attract the north pole of another magnet. It shows that the same poles repel each other, as you can see in the diagram. If you bring the north pole of a magnet near to the south pole of another magnet, what they will? They will attract each other. It shows that the opposite poles attract each other. A magnet is a piece of iron or steel which can attract objects made of metals like iron, steel, nickel, and cobalt. The metal which can be attracted by a magnet are known as magnetic materials. Materials which are not attracted by magnets are known as non-magnetic, like glass, plastic, and wood. Are example of non-magnetic material, as we learn in the previous chapter that glass, plastic, and wood, they are insulator. Do you remember this? Same, they are the example of non-magnetic materials. Magnet never attract non-metallic objects. Students, you see on your screen that both north poles repel each other and both south poles repel each other. But here, north and south pole attract each other. Magnetic field. A magnetic field is a field that describes the magnetic influence on moving electric charges, electric currents, and magnetized materials. Magnetic field. Every magnetic is surrounded by a magnetic field. The magnetic field is the area around the magnet where its force is the strongest. Though this force is invisible, you can make it visible. We cannot see the force which makes a magnetic field, but we can make this possible to see or visible. What will we do? Place a flat piece of paper over a bar magnet. Sprinkle some iron fillings over it. As you can see in the diagram, tape the paper, observe what happens. You can trace the magnetic fields around a magnet by using a magnetic compass also. A magnetic compass is a simple magnet that can move in the direction of the Earth's north and south. You see in the diagram, there is a simple bar and the piece of paper over there, and the iron filling is sprinkled on it. And when we use a compass, it will make the magnetic field here. You see easily, this is magnetic field. Demagnetization. Demagnetization means that how we lose the power of magnet. How long a magnet can remain a magnet depends on how you handle it. Magnets can lose their power of attraction if they are not handled carefully or stored properly. When a magnet loses its power, we say that it has become demagnetized. It means that the meaning of demagnetization is when the magnet loses its power, then we said that magnet demagnetized. This can happen if magnets. Now we have some properties due to which any magnet can demagnetize. Number one, drop repeatedly. If we heated the magnet, if we hammered it, kept close to each other when not in use. If we kept together the magnets and we don't use them, they demagnetized. Here you see that when we burn the bar magnet and if we hammered it, then the magnet become demagnetized. In this topic, we will learn that how we can create the electromagnet. In the previous, we see that how magnet is demagnetized. Now creating an electromagnet. Electromagnets can be created by wrapping a wire around an iron nail and running current through the wire. The electric field in the wire coil creates a magnetic field around the nail. In some cases, the nail will remain magnetized even when removed from within the wire coil. On page 101, creating an electromagnet. There are methods of creating your own magnet. One of these is the use of electric current. If we pass the electric current to any iron object, it will become a magnet. But this is a complete process. If we adopt it, we can change the nail or any iron object in magnet. Let us see that what is the process. Electricity can be used to change magnetic materials into magnets. Such magnets are called electromagnets. Because we use electricity, so that's why that type of magnet are called electromagnets. An electromagnet is a type of magnet that can be turned off. An electromagnet consists of a coil of wire wound by a core of soft, easily magnetized iron, such as a nail. When an electric current is passed through the wire, the iron behaves like a magnet. Means if we wrap a nail with the coil, with the wire of coil, and when current passes from it, the nail becomes a magnet. This electromagnet produces a strong magnetic field. Because electric current produces the magnetic field, so that's why the nail becomes a magnet. And that magnet will be called electromagnet. It can be switched on or off. With a simple homemade electromagnet, you can attract a needle floating on a cord in water. You can increase the strength of an electromagnet by increasing the number of coils around the iron. If we increase the number of coils around the nail or around the iron, we can make the strength. We can increase the strength of electromagnet, or if we increase the flow of the current in the wire, in both ways. Here you see, this is the example. This is an iron bar and a coil is wrapped around it. Here student, you see this is a battery. It provides electricity to the nail. And these loops are the wire, which shows the coil of wire. Here you see, when we connect the wire, the nails, the bar of iron convert into the magnet. Here also you see, when we join this wire with the cell, the magnetic compass moves. In the last topic, we see that in our daily life, we can use electromagnets. Electromagnets are widely used as components of other electrical devices, such as motors, generators, electromechanical solenoids, relays, loudspeakers, hard disks, MRI machines, scientific instruments, and magnetic separation equipment. The ability to control magnetism is very useful for us. Due to this ability, electromagnets are used in a number of devices in our daily life. Electromagnets are used in the speakers of TVs, radios, tape recorders, in motors, and computer hard devices. Number two, electromagnets are used in doorbells and generators. Number three, they are used to separate metals in scrap yards. The electromagnet is able to pick up great weight. It attracts only the iron and the steel in the scrap heap. Number four, metal frames have electromagnets attached below them. You see here the picture of the train. This is called metal train and it moves due to the electromagnetism. The track as well as the train contain powerful electromagnets. These magnets are adjusted in a way that magnets at the bottom of the train and on the surface of the track face the same poles. For example, the track contains magnets in which the north pole faces upward. The train contains magnet in which the north pole faces downwards. And you know that the same pole repels each other. So in this way, when train moves on the track, they both have the same pole, so they repel each other. And due to this, train moves forward. Since similar poles repel each other, when the electricity is turned on, the train floats slightly above the track. Yes, students, this is the picture of the scrap electromagnet who pick up the iron from the scrap heap. You see that this machine pick up the iron only from the scrap heap. This is also, and they are able to pick up the great weight. Okay, students, let us take a quick review of our chapter. A magnet is a material or object that produces a magnet. Magnet field is invisible but is responsible for the most notable property of a magnet. And in the diagram, you can see easily that the same poles repulse each other. The second is magnetic field. A magnetic field is a field that describes the magnetic influence on moving electric charges, electric currents, and magnetized materials. You see, this is the diagram of magnetic field. These are the example of demagnetization, how we can demagnetize an iron. If we burn it or if we heat, when we hammer the iron, if we drop it repeatedly, or if we kept close to each other when not is used, then the magnets become demagnetized. Electromagnets can be created by wrapping wire around the iron nail, and when passing through the current, the electric field in the wire coil creates a magnetic field around the nail. In some cases, the nail will remain magnetized even when removed from within the wire coil. And in the example, you see that when we join a wire with a battery or with a cell, the magnetic compass moves. Electromagnets are widely used components of other electrical devices such as motors, generators, electromagnetical solenoids, relay, loudspeakers, hard disk, MRI machines, scientific instruments, and the magnetic separation equipment. These are the use of electromagnet. And also, this is an example of metal train is also the example of magnet electromagnets in our daily life. Come to the exercise. Question number one. Write T for the statement which are true and F for the ones which are false. Number one is magnetism is a type of electricity. False. Magnets attract only steel or iron objects. True. Magnets can never lose their magnetism. False. The magnetic field of a magnet is the area of force around it. True. Electromagnets cannot be switched on and off. False. Fill in the blanks. A piece of iron or steel which can attract the object made of iron or steel is called a magnet. Number two, the area around a magnet where its force of attraction can be felt is called the magnetic field. Number three, opposite poles of a magnet attract each other while similar poles repel each other. Number four, the process or method by which a magnet loses its power is called demagnetization. Number five, an iron nail can be turned into a magnet by passing electric current around it. Such a magnet is known as an electromagnet. Question answer, define the following terms. Magnetic and non-magnetic materials, magnetic field. Question number two is what is meant by demagnetization? Explain any three ways to magnetize a magnet. First, we will write the definition of demagnetization and then you will mention their three types. Question number three, what are electromagnets? Question number four, how can you turn an iron nail into a magnet? Question number five, how can you increase the strength of an electromagnet? Write any three uses of electromagnets in daily life. You can write any three uses. We learn 4 to 5 uses over here, but in the question, according to the question, you can write only 3. A special toy train is able to float above its track. Use your knowledge about magnetic repulsion to explain how it is done. With this question, we have complete our chapter 16, electromagnet. Okay, students, inshallah, we will meet with the next lecture 23 with the next new chapter. Allah Hafiz.